Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to round three of GPS Rugby. My name is Martin Lippiatt, and this afternoon we're bringing you all the action live from Ipswich Grammar School in the heart of Ipswich. We're not at their Brassel Sporting Fields complex. We are at the school's sacred ground. Played the majority of their games here over the years, and what a history it's been between these two schools. Ipswich Grammar, 48 wins. BBC, 44. Ipswich Grammar, they need 6 more points to get a total of 1,500 points cumulatively against BBC in their history. But here, it's a different story. BBC have won 17 out of 17 times against Ipswich Grammar here at their home field. Ipswich Grammar, only 14. Weather conditions here are pretty windy. We got the wonderful August westerlies powering in. So quite gusty day, but still quite warm out there under the sun. We get a little bit of break here from the main building where all of our cameras are positioned. Wonderful weather and a wonderful day, round three, and it's an important game for both of these sides. And we're going to get right into the team list, and we're going to be looking at those eventually. But now we're going to be looking at what's going on. We've got Terrace and Churchy. We've got Brisbane Grammar up against Southport, and Toowoomba Grammar will be hosting Nudgee up the range, a little further west from where we are right now. We can hear the sounds of teams getting ready to head out. It looks like BBC are wasting no time, but we're going to start with Ipswich. They are without Ben Murphy, the hooker, who is also in charge of their goal-kicking duties this week. But out front, we have Mataafa, Tamilo and Hemi. Stowers will be working at half for number 8. Good halves pairing of O'Sullivan and Ali. And out the back, Ethan King, number 1 in the competition for try assists with 2. And it's looking like a pretty good field out wide. Malik Dolthert-Schoberg, another one there to keep an eye on. We look at the visitors here, and they are in fine form. I've only had one premiership in the whole existence of this competition, so they're going to be out. They're 1-0. They got a good win 2 weeks ago against Brisbane Grammar. They're coming in fresh off the bye. They're looking strong up front. Romano, Guest and Hansen in the front row. Zach Hoff, 2 tries in that opening game. Keep your eyes on him too. He's really a Cinderella story. We'll get into that later. In the halves, Faimalo and Gordon, and then the back 3 are looking lethal as well. Guy Wallace, Lachlan Rubens and Jared Homan. And here come the home side now, led out by Ethan King, who has taken over captaincy roles after Seamus King-Smith regrettably hurt his shoulder again in the Nudgee matchup this season, just like he did last year. So a couple of big changes there for Ipswich Grammar. They're obviously without their line-out thrower and gun conversion extraordinaire front rower hooker in Ben Murphy. So there's going to be some big shoes to fill for the home side. And Ipswich Grammar, they're a real potential to go all the way this year. They take on Southport next week, so they really need to keep it 2-0 if they want to keep their eyes on the prize, and that's a GPS premiership.
All good, fellas?
And we're away, round 3. Ipswich Grammar hosting BBC here at Ipswich Grammar School on their main field. Oh, one's out. Strong run there from Milne. There's Andrew Romano. 6 tackle breaks leading into this game. Former Rockhampton player.
Take a step.
It's his second year in the competition. Big future for him. They're going to kick for some territory out back. It's going to be allowed to bounce. Dixon will be on that. Picks it up. He's got some green jerseys coming at him. Gets a past one. Gets the offload. That one's gone. Forward's been knocked on. Still in play, but now it's been lost.
First by what?
So it's going to be a BBC scrum inside Ipswich Grammar's 22.
Scrum down, fellas. Scrum down.
Big attacking opportunity here for the college.
Big scrum, fight, let's go. Big scrum, BBC, let's go. Let's push.
Faimalo, tap on the back, throws it in. BBC getting the ascendancy, a bit of push, he's had enough, he throws it out. There's Gordon, throws it out. Good run there from Howarth. So BBC camped inside the 22. Strong run from Howarth. BBC ploughing towards the line.
Take a step.
Looking for their options. They're looking close and they're over. BBC, first try. So BBC draw first blood here in the second minute of play. They're not wasting any time. Andrew Romano, he's been marked as a kid with a big future in the rugby hemisphere. Vice captain today, like we said, former Rockhampton resident. And that conversion will be unsuccessful for Mason Gordon. So BBC in the lead, 5-0 here. So Ipswich Grammar will bring themselves back to halfway and it'll be another Zach Alley restart. Great follow-up pressure from that kick in play from BBC. Forced the error from Ipswich. Wobbly start there. Oh, and they've managed to get away with it. That was spectacular. Ipswich Grammar making the moves. Quick 1, 2, 3 over the line. Nick Mitchell. Won't be enough. There's going to be a knock forward in that. Oh. It wasn't the prettiest of kicks, but it nearly went off without a hitch. Ipswich Grammar. Aaron Pook, our referee, out in the middle. He was assisting with the refereeing effort last night down the Gold Coast. Mighty Queensland Reds getting the win over the Force. We're very fortunate up here in Queensland being able to play rugby like this, and it's an even bigger pleasure to be able to bring it to all of our fans, not only in Australia but overseas as well. Some good content to watch on a Saturday afternoon, and that scrum has descended. BBC taking their time. Williams picks and goes. Fomalo, Gordon. There's the kick from Annan. And he'll find touch, but he was outside the 22. So a big opportunity here for Ipswich. Set piece. First line out of the day. They had a wonderful game 2 weeks ago against Toowoomba Grammar. Their first win, but it wasn't their week last weekend against Nudgee. Couldn't get a point on the board. Five-man option is spoiled in the middle. Fomalo, Gordon. He's got a wonderful spread of players out to the left, but it's a strong run from Anand. Back up the middle. Finding his supporting forwards. Howarth getting driven back. Fomalo's got to work over some of those Ipswich players in the ruck there to try and get the clearance. And another wonderful kick from BBC. Just in front of the 22, it's in the hands of Dixon, who punches it low and flat. It'll be allowed to bounce, but scooped up by Homan. Who gives it to Gordon, throws on to the right foot, but gets brought down by his opposite alley. Fomalo looks over to the left. On the left-hand wing, Goai Wallace tearing up through the middle before he's brought down by a stiff Saipili Tamilo shoulder. And now a turnover conceded by BBC, so Ipswich. With a kick to come for that line out. You can just see the bunting on the far side of the field is absolutely flailing in the wind here. It is gusty. So we're probably going to see a lot of line out activity on the far side of the field today. So BBC, a 1-0 for spoiled line outs. Ipswich Grammar are going to have to rejig their thinking and find a winning option. Throw an extra man in, go the six man. They go up the front. Stowers has missed it this time, so BBC wonderfully sabotaging the Ipswich line out. Now BBC getting to work from inside their own 40. Great offloading will end up in the hands of Carl Hansen.
Off there, White!
Kick from Gordon, charging onto it with a head of steam is Rubens. Oh, but that ball will just find the touchline. So BBC showing a lot of creativity in their attack. Now Ipswich will field the line out just inside their own 40-metre line. Tamilo hits the middle. Wasn't terribly clean off the top, but Ipswich, it's their first successful line out of the day. Now they've fielding rucks inside their own 40. Alley, short ball to Tupi, who manages to offload himself. Oh, and the knock on there from Ipswich Grammar. That'll be lost forward. BBC now will feed their scrum. just outside of the Ipswich red zone. We look at the history of these two teams, and when we think about the games played here, Ipswich Grammar generally brought at least one game back here a season, in a regular season, but obviously with COVID it's different. And I don't think they'll soon to be get back. In 2018, BBC beat them here 55 points to 12. And BBC would know that coming in, and they probably want to keep up the tradition and try and keep them on. But Ipswich Grammar, you can see there's some points early on, but now they're really going to have to dig in deep and try and keep the green machine out. Pulling on the right-hand side, Howarth goes through, throwing some big stiff arms at the defenders. They can't get him down, 7 metres out. By Marlo Gordon. They're going to work it across the other side of the field. Up is Homan. He's going to go himself, and he's through. Jared Homan gets the second for BBC in the opening 10 minutes of play. BBC are not mucking around this afternoon. So second try to BBC. The fullback, Jared Homan. Mason Gordon will be looking for the extras, and it was a wonderful run here from Jack Howarth, which set it up. Took nearly four Ipswich defenders to neutralise him before it opened up a lot of real estate on the far side of the field, and it was just as simple as running it through the hands, seeing the gap, splitting a defence, and that's all she wrote. A young Mason Gordon now, equal first for try assist in the comp. He's the brother of Carter. Mason was the star water boy for the season documentary of BBC last year. And he's 0-2 today. So BBC in the lead, 10 points to nil over Ipswich. Setting a blistering pace here in the first half. Point a minute. Alley goes high. Now that one will go back to Gordon. Here goes Stowers. Doesn't back off. Stowers is part of the Mal Meninga side, plays for the Ipswich Jets. Doesn't shy away from long-range contact like that. Now, Ipswich Grammar. Great offloads. Left-hand side is a good run from Tupi. He's still going. BBC struggling to get him to the ground. Alley fires across centre of the field, and they find Mataafa. Advantage being played to Ipswich Grammar. King had Stowers with him. Down the short side, there's the great pass into the hands of Dolthard Schoberg, and he's going to, nearly gets away from the second tackle. But they're going to come back for the advantage. What a run there from Malik Dolthard Schoberg. Picked up two tries over the last 2 weeks. Equal first in the competition, four line breaks. The second year in the first 15. Great vision there from Braden O'Sullivan. Dolthard Schoberg shrugs off Wallace, but it was a great second effort there from Jared Homan to stop the man. And no surprise there, Ipswich Grammar opting to go for the scrum. The success rate with the line-out hasn't been great today, so they're going to play to a bit of security here. They've got a good-looking forward pack, especially some good size in that front row.
Crouch! Vaughan! Set! Yeah. But the bind, yeah, I get that, but fellas, the bind, there's so much movement going, okay, from our both packs here. The feet, stable them up, okay? Way too much movement.
And some familiar faces, not only from rugby union, also rugby league. The one, the only, Lottie Takiri. spectating from the sidelines.
Crouch!
Go, big push, big push, big push!
Bond! Set!
And a penalty going against Ipswich. They had a golden opportunity here, but the BBC scrum too strong. Big taps there for Andrew Romano. BBC are going to have to have a flawless game today in preparation for Southport next week. And we just see this scrum right now. Wonderful up and drive there from Romano on the far side.
Hit one just off.
BBC, quick line out. Oh, sticky hands from Hugo Percival. Supplies good ball for the backs, who are met by some stiff Ipswich Grammar defence.
Off wide.
Faimalo to the right. Gordon hits the traffic hard. A try scorer, one of them, Andrew Romano. And it looks like we might have an injury here for Ipswich Grammar. Might be a cramp, but that big shot we saw just before. Clean, wonderful line out. Faimalo sends it out. And if you're going to run a pair of people, Jed Bignall and Winniata Hemi are probably not the two you want to run at. Jump into that tackle, but it will benefit them a penalty. While we've got a bit of time here, let's have a look at the history for both of these schools. BBC have won the last three matchups against Ipswich Grammar over the years previous. And Ipswich Grammar, obviously, they moved the majority of their home games to Brassel in 2014, their sporting fields. And since then, they have not won a single match here at their home ground in the school at Ipswich Grammar. So there's a lot riding here. You know, they're going to break a bit of hoodoo, try and get themselves a win here at home. Sure, they can't have the same home crowds because of coronavirus and all of the things associated with that. So a lot riding here for Ipswich Grammar. They're down by 10 points as we are about to enter the 16th minute of play.
Yes.
We have a look at some of the games that are here. They lost narrowly last year to Churchy, 24 points to 22. 2017, 41 to 28 against Nudgee. And there's that infamous 2013 year where Ipswich Grammar had such a hard time against Churchy and Nudgee, who were just stacked to the gills. Churchy getting that 53-0 and then 71-17. And that kick will not find touch, even with the wind assist. Now Ipswich Grammar going through the middle, and that is a huge hit from Tarjanan. Has cleaned him up. Kick from Bignall. Ipswich Grammar get the line out win. Moving it through the hands a little bit too quick. It's been scooped up by Rubens. BBC on the counter attack. Howarth.
Attack release! Yeah, he already got it. That's fine.
And the strip was enforced. Ipswich Grammar now back with the ball in hand. Realigning their backs to the right. Good hands there from Matt Taafa.
Release!
I beg your pardon.
Let it come! He's through the gate, that's fine.
A lot of pressure at the ruck from BBC have got Ipswich Grammar stalling, going backwards. Strike from Ali downtown, fielded well by Rubens. Links up into the centre with Homan. Goes once more over to Wallace, who gets a pass off. Here goes Gordon, who throws it on the toe. No flag from the sideline. A good net gain there from BBC.
You've got to use some arms there, okay?
Attacking set piece inside Ipswich Grammar 22.
Come on, fellas, I'll manage them. Come in, boys, come in.
Wonderful hands once more from Percival. Driving maul, we'll see the ball return to Harvey Guest's hands.
Use it now!
He gives it to Faimalo. Ooh, and Faimalo throws it at the bootlaces of Mason Gordon. So Ipswich Grammar will feed their own scrum. Not the best pass from Faimalo. Ipswich Grammar at the other end of the field managed to get a wonderful penalty courtesy of Andrew Romano.
Crouch! Boy! Set!
BBC putting the pressure on Ipswich Grammar off the back. Stowers goes before he offloads it to Dalton Schoberg. Not the best of kicks. Now the counter-attack from BBC. And Ipswich Grammar putting the pressure on. And Rubens is driven over the sideline. What a huge effort by his opposite, Kyle Colburn. BBC definitely came out of the blocks sprinting in the first 10 minutes of play. But Ipswich Grammar, they're finding form and they're starting to read their opposition. And the game has moved more into the middle of the field now. A lot of opportunities for them.
All right, fellas, I hate to stop it, but you can't come straight in and jump. You must
have
come
to err on the side of caution. Right? Oliver Mill and Hugo Percival.
No, fellas, so you're here, you're in, okay?
Thieving throws all game. They managed to balk the jump and then get the man up and get the ball. 1-2 into the hands of Fruin.
Boss. Good.
Stowers. One-on-one with Romano, but Romano gets his man in the end. And now BBC turnover. Hanson gets past one, loses it forward. And they're going to offload it here to King. King, who gets an offload of his own through to Colburn. And Colburn is striding away. Try for Ipswich Grammar. Left-hand side. They're on the scoreboard. 5-10 with a conversion to come. And the back and forth there from Ipswich Grammar losing the ball at a breakdown. Ipswich regathering, and then right there it gets turned over through, and then they offload it through to King, who drags the defenders, creates space. Great peace of mind there from Kyle Colburn. He may be a bit of a skinny, tall drink of water, Colburn, but he is quick. And BBC just had to sit back and watch him stride through. That's another try for Colburn. That's his third for the season. So wonderful effort there from Kyle Colburn, and it'll be good for Ipswich Grammar. They're on the board. They didn't get on the board last week against Nudgee, so they're off to a good start. And now the conversion attempt coming from Luke Dixon. Dixon goes left to the post. Conversion unsuccessful. So Ipswich Grammar trailing BBC 5-10. It's really interesting where we're positioned up high here. We can hear and see the trees rustling and heaving from these big westerlies. And down there in particular parts of the oval, we're not seeing any of the bunting moving at all. So different wind conditions down on the field. A lot of protection here from the buildings and the geography around it. There's the restart from Gordon, taken well by Stowers. Now they've spread out. They've got a four-man spread here on the short side, but King will take it himself right into traffic. Another player. He's also equal first try assists Ethan King, and I think he's probably just added another one to his name after the effort he just did then before. Setting up Colburn, but another player part of that Malmeninga squad with the Ipswich Jets. He's been part of this first 15 set up now for a couple of years at Ipswich Grammar. Ipswich Grammar, one of the zippiest back lines. Great touches. Tomillo. Tomillo tries to get to Stowers at the back, but it's spoiled by BBC. They're reading them like a book. Gordon throws a wonderful flat double cut out wide to Wallace. Once more on the outside, into the hands of Homan. Homan's going down, doesn't have much field to work with. He's bumped off three defenders, and he's in the corner. That is big. Big try. He's lost a boot in the process. That is a big try for BBC down the left side after we saw Ipswich Grammar starting to get some momentum and some field position. The counter-attack from BBC has been lethal and quick this afternoon. See this double cutout gets to Wallace. Jack Howarth works really hard, gets on the outside, didn't have much grass to work with down that sideline, lost a boot. The boot left the field of play before he did, and another conversion will be unsuccessful there. So it's a game of five so far. BBC in the lead, 15 points to 5 over Ipswich Grammar. Fun facts for Jack Howarth. He is probably one of the best Australian schoolboys going around at the moment. And I'm told he's benching about 160 kilos. Which is monstrous. He's been signed with the Melbourne Storm in the NRL. I believe he's playing also, he's affiliated with the East Tigers in Brisbane as well. So, big future for him. Now BBC once again lining it up down that left-hand side. Here goes Ween.
Off the foot.
Loose ball, and Ipswich will not be able to turn it over. Wallace picks it up, goes from the back, shows and goes before Stower says, come here, and puts him down. Marlo Gordon. And a big floating pass out wide into Hoff. Here he goes. The Hoff is over. Zach Hoff, what a try. And BBC have been hot on the counter-attack. And what a story it is for Zach Hoff. It's his third try for the season. In 2019, he was the leading forward in line breaks, and he had a late start to the season. The coaches saw him playing in the 16As. They said, get up here, have a go. And within 10 minutes, they realised the potential this kid had. Even so much so, some people are dubbing him Artie Surveyor 2.0. So a wonderful try there, being fully aware of his surroundings. And this will probably be our first conversion of the day, unless I put the mocker on him. There are some flags. So BBC extend the lead now, 22 points to 5 here at the Ipswich Grammar School main field. You can see in the background there, that is eyes into the main city centre of Ipswich, West Brisbane. And even further west of us now, Toowoomba Grammar are hosting Nudgee up the range. Ooh, and that was a seatbelt of a tackle. And BBC will... It's on the try scorer, Zach Hoff.
Ethan. Who's captain? Where is he? Captain. Captain. Two. That's right, we can do it on the run. It's two our tackles already, and we had a late one before as well, okay? Mate, I don't want to repeat it last week, right? Have a word.
Oh,
Keep going, guys. Keep going.
That line out uncontested by Ipswich Grammar. BBC will throw to a driving maul, and Harvey Guest just sitting out the back with it as they slowly trudge their way forward. Now they're getting some momentum. Ipswich Grammar are going to have to commit some bodies here if they want to slow it down. They haven't given away a penalty infringement yet, but BBC are going to keep on wandering, meandering their way downtown. There's the 22. Anxious eyes of Harvey Guest are watching to see if there's any opportunities down the short side. But Faimalo's had enough. Gordon. Short, quick, simple passing between these BBC forwards is finding a lot of valuable space. Meterage a past the advantage line. Annan straightens up, cops a nasty shoulder from Fruin before he rolls off and goes all the way through, but he will just be short. Ipswich Grammar looking for the pilfer. By Marlowe looks to the left, the show and go from Gordon. Gordon can't get there. Now they're going through. BBC find the try, a darting run there from the halfback Perrin Faimalo. Bit of claret there on his left shin. A war wound. And a wonderful try there for Faimalo. BBC's fifth of the game.
Yes, not first man, okay? So they've got to be first man on the ball. What happens? Straight over.
Look at the competition table. BBC are now sitting second. A win today will be big for them. And Carter Gordon really disrupted the Ipswich Grammar defence. And there was that space right on the fringe of the breakdown. And good eyes up vision from Perrin Faimalo. Put him through. And kicking duties have rotated to Taj Annan. Taj Annan, who going into today's round, currently sits in at fourth, was sitting in at fourth. So he's already got 12 points to his name. Can he make it 14? Bit of a low missile of a kick. Won't be successful, but BBC in the lead, 27 points to 5 here. In the 31st minute of play. Ali high, short with that one. Oh, and it's snatched out of the air by Tupi, who drives through. Ipswich Grammar, players are plenty on the left. They're going to go one more over, and it's a double for Colburn. Kyle Colburn picks up the double. The zip man on the left-hand side has really made sure he was in the right place at the right time and delivered exactly what you want to see from a number 14. Wonderful, wonderful execution. But it started from the kickoff. Leonardo Tupi flew in with such grace, nabs it out of the air. BBC are caught napping. They're on the back foot. Great 1-2 to find Mitchell, who gets the offload to Colburn, and they get there for a wonderful try. And it was just an ambush tactic there, and it's good to see off that restart. And now it'll fall back to the boot of Luke Dixon. And with that try, Ipswich Grammar have passed an impressive milestone. They have scored 1,504 points against BBC in matches dating back to 1924. What a rich history this competition has. Oh, as he bent it like Beck. Ooh, just short. Just short. Luke Dixon got that little bit of right to left, that bit of a fade on that kick. And trying to make it work into this wind. He's a pretty scary monster. We're back to the middle. Mason Gordon. Ends it high, but he finds probably one of the safest pair of hands the Ipswich Grammar has in Stowers, and also one of the most raging bull run forwards they've got as well. Now Ipswich Grammar, they are liking the left-hand side of the field, giving offloads back to the danger man, Colburn. He throws it onto the foot. Ricochet touch there off BBC. He'll send it back to Ipswich Grammar. They're looking like things are starting to fire for them. Ipswich Grammar, great continuity of play. So Ipswich Grammar, the lineouts have been an issue for them today. Quick at the front, and that'll do them. The KISS principle, if I've ever seen it. Great lines there by Ipswich Grammar in the middle. Swain that time. O'Sullivan goes to this left-hand short side to find Stowers, who is dragging defenders up the field.
Feel that to me.
O'Sullivan, great hands, 1, 2, 3, boom! Goes Mataafa. Now the right-hand side, King sizes up the defense, bumps off one, gets away from two, gets away from three. For his opposite center, Taj Annan jumps in and slows him down. They've got penalty advantage. Quick one from Ali across to Stowers, who goes back onto the inside to find Swain.
That's a good steal, it's legal, okay? High tackle. Again. Mason.
Still a lot of rugby to play as we draw to the end of the first half. Ipswich Grammar, if they could come away with a try here. Ooh. But not with a kick like that. And that is a wonderful save from Goai Wallace.
All right, you got to keep coming. Hold, hold green, no hold.
Ipswich Grammar going quick into the centre. Luke Dixon against the counter. Throws in a little goosey before a very... scary Jack Howarth special came running at him. Ball's lost, but now it returns back to Ipswich Grammar. From his ankles, King fishes it out. Great defensive lines from BBC are slowing them down a little bit, but Ipswich Grammar are finding territory.
Take a step here, Green. Green, take a step.
O'Sullivan. Alley. Bignall that time. Cut out pass from King. Great 1-2, but that ball's lost on the ground. And Colburn will take that one in to the ruck. King, not the cleanest of pass through, but it'll end up with Ali, who'll get a kick off. And there's a bit of a touch there. Wallace will dive on it. Half time looming. Ipswich slicing right up through the middle, goes Annan. Annan goes through, unopposed, fends off 2-3, but brought down spectacularly by Dolphit Schoberg.
Oh, off! Watch off sides here.
By Marlowe, finds Gordon, who gives a quick one off to Romano, who charges through. Romano!
Held up.
Held up spectacularly by Nick Mitchell, but that will be halftime. BBC in an impressive position. 27 points to 10 over Ipswich Grammar here at Ipswich Grammar's main field at their school grounds in Ipswich. A wonderful first half of rugby union. Ipswich Grammar showing that they're still in the fight and they're going to be bringing it to BBC in the second half. And that second half is not too far away. We're going to take a short break here and we'll be back with all that action very shortly. Halftime here at Ipswich Grammar School between BBC and the home side. And we have a look at the ladder going into today's match. And Southport, they're sitting up the top 2-0 on 4 points. BBC, they're also up there with their victory in round one against Brisbane Grammar School. Then as we look down, Nudgee, Churchy, Ipswich. If Ipswich can get the win today, it'll keep them in contention of the top half of the board. But BBC, they really want to get this win with Southport next week. They want to have a bit of a run in. But let's have a quick check-in moments before we go into this second half about what's been happening with the rest of the GPS competition. And we see what a match it must be between Terrace and Churchy. High scoring, 38-24, but Terrace getting that win, really putting their authority on that one. Nil all between Brisbane Grammar and Southport School. Something going on there. Pretty exciting stuff. And then Nudgee College looking strong against Toowoomba, 21-0 up the range. And I tell you what, it's blowing pretty hard down the range here. I can only imagine at the top, it's going to be howling and it's going to be chilly. And we're out in the middle now for the restart. BBC in the lead against Ipswich Grammar. Second half just moments away.
Good to go.
And we're away, second half. Ipswich Grammar hosting BBC. And another phenomenal take there from Xavier Stowers.
No hands, no hands!
17 points the deficit. That is the mountain that Ipswich Grammar need to climb if they want to find the lead for the first time in this game. Hard-hitting run, though, from Ethan King. Loose ball at the back. So BBC have come out of the blocks firing, just like they did in the first half. Only one successful conversion today, and it was right in front of the sticks, so the windy conditions are wreaking havoc with the kickers today.
Crouch! Bourne!
Perrin Faimalo.
Set!
Picked up a great try next to the sticks, other end of the field. Feeds it in. Gordon straightens up, breaks through the defensive line. Gordon goes himself and he is there. Mason Gordon gets the try and opens up the second half account for BBC, who now lead 32 points to 10 over Ipswich Grammar. A good confidence here from Gordon. Manages to bust the tackle of Luke Dixon. And then the rest of the defenders tried to get there in time, but they just didn't have enough field to work with to try and slow him down. Taj Hannon looking to add the extras. He strikes and finds the flags. So BBC extend the lead, 34 points to 10 over Ipswich Grammar here on a gusty Saturday afternoon in August. Not many days of winter left. We're nearly in spring. It's a very odd time of year to see this kind of rugby still taking place the way it is. That's coronavirus, ladies and gentlemen. Really threw a spanner in the works with a lot of people. We're very fortunate to be able to be here and have these games playing. And it's great for the schoolboys. Get to finish this up in a very nice way for their senior year, for those of them in year 12. But it'll be Ipswich Grammar now with a scrum on the 22.
Crouch! Bourne!
Centre pairings of Bignall and King have been unreal today for Ipswich Grammar. Just got to get the ball to them. But another big scrum from BBC. Ali out the back finds King. King gets away from two. Now Ipswich Grammar
back.
They like spontaneous play, but a wild pass to Ali. They're going to move it once more out wide. Here's Dolphin. Schulberg keeps it in the field of play. Back into the hands of Dixon. And now substitution, Nat Fox in the 19 jersey. King throws a big pass to Bignall, who finds Fruin in space. Ipswich Grammar off the cuff. They're very dangerous. Here's Tupi. O'Sullivan. Bignall backdoors to Ali, who straightens up himself, but he's dealing with the Hoff. Just Grammar, they got a wonderful spread of players, but all coming a bit off, a bit flat-footed, and that ball is spat out like a pumpkin seed.
Then you're going on the ball.
But it'll return to Ipswich Grammar, who'll get the penalty. A referee for today's match, Aaron Pook, out in the middle.
All right, scrum.
He's risen up through the ranks, seen him do a lot of work with Queensland Premier Rugby, and been in and around Super Rugby system as well. And we're very fortunate to have such high-quality referees available to the competition to be able to come down here, and you need them. The quality of the competition in the last 10 years, it's really skyrocketed. We're seeing the professionalism of the players, the teams, the coaches go up and up and up. It's a testament to all the hard work that everyone puts in around this competition.
Set!
The wonderful camera operators here with double take getting us best angles that really paint the picture of what's happening down there. And Ipswich Grammar, they're going to get another penalty.
Got to push square, boys.
The quick tap and go. Bignall goes back to his stationary pack of forwards. Here's Stowers. O'Sullivan, King, Swain.
Strip. Back on green, okay.
King, yep. Ducking and weaving, trying to find a bit of daylight to go through.
Nah, it's not out.
Now they're just going to give it to the forwards. Shore things up, try to find some field position. Caterpillar of them just waiting in line to truck it up. They're slowly finding meters over the advantage line. Ali, crossfield kick, running hard onto it is Dolphin Schulberg. He's putting the pressure on. They let that one bounce. Oh, Schulberg manages to bat it back in the field of play, but BBC will be the ones that receive it before a... Whee! Another strip there.
So we're playing the line out here. Line out.
Dolphin Schulberg nearly pulled off a bit of a miracle there, keeping in the field of play. So we see Zach Alley. He's spicing up, trying to do something a little bit different. And you see Dolphin Schulberg had his foot on the line and left the field of play when he moved that one in.
Chat there, fellas. Give him time.
Harvey Guest. His first wayward one of the day. They'll still hold on to it. BBC inside their own 22, and a penalty. Big turnover, quick tap and go there from O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan goes straight forward into the fence. Ipswich Grammar 7 metres out. Looking for their third try of the day. Now they've got another penalty advantage. BBC have got to be careful here. They've given a lot away inside their own 22. Aaron Poop, he could be reaching for the pocket soon if this doesn't slow up. But Ipswich Grammar rolling through the phase count here, ploughing ever closer to the line. There's a good push from Tupi. They're getting very close, good continuity. BBC are just on the back foot trying to slow this down. Some big body forwards from Ipswich Grammar really putting the hurt on in the meters department.
Take a step.
Good placing technique from Ipswich Grammars, keeping them in the fight. Another penalty advantage. Ipswich Grammar, a lot of work been put in here. They want to walk away with something. And there's space out wide. Schoelberg's through. Schoelberg is there. Malik Delvert-Schoelberg goes through and gets a fantastic try. And in some ways, BBC might be just a little bit lucky here because they gave away about three successive penalties during that set of play. And the 5 points that they've given away compared to a yellow card could be a little bit of a saving grace for them. And wonderful try there for Malik Delpit-Schoelberg. It'll be his third. Third for the season. He was equal first in line breaks going into today's game. He was toted last year as probably being one of the most exciting high-scoring players in the competition, but injury really shut the door on him in 2019. Looks like he's making up for lost time in 2020. And that right to left from Luke Dixon. Very hard hitting across the face with that, and that wind behind it as well. He's almost going to have to aim right of the right-hand post to try and curve that one in. There's the restart from BBC. Wonderful spread once more from Ipswich Grammar. They really are efficient at setting up a nice spread of players with options. King goes right up through the middle, hurdles over Fox.
Taken back Sullivan. Oh, 12, 12, stop.
Feeds it into it. Kick downtown before it's scooped up by Annan. Hasn't been too much possession for BBC in the last 10 minutes. Romano putting on the silky pirouette through the defenders, but Ipswich Grammar finding another penalty at the breakdown once more. 19 points separate these two teams. So it's three converted tries with a lot of rugby still to play. So BBC, you're going to have to be careful here. And now Ipswich Grammar moving down into their territory. They've got to be careful. Big Xavier Stowers. Biggest timber on that team. Getting down, getting grass on the knuckles and getting the hard work done. Ali finds King, who straightens up before a wonderful tackle brings him down. O'Sullivan, Ali, Hemi, King offers the short ball through to Tupi. Show and go there from Fruin. And now the turnover from BBC is good. They're looking down the right-hand side. And it's a great run from Milne.
No, let it come.
Fine, Marlow fires it through. Finally gets his hands on the ball. It's been a while for the halfback. Ipswich Grammar controlling a lot of possession in the second half. And now Gordon dinks one through. Wallace was charging onto that one, but he wraps up Dixon, who fires it back. And they won't find touch, and Gordon will get that one, and he'll charge straight in to traffic. Gets past one before he's slammed in the deck by Fruin. Quick 1-2 to Hoff. Hoff showing some silky touches with the hand. They're going to keep pulling through. Howarth goes through unopposed. You're not going to stop that juggernaut. And that is his second for the day, and BBC return fire in the lead now, 39 points to Ipswich Grammar's 15. So we see it really was this man here, Zach Hoff, and we see he's juking and driving, getting the hands free around the corner, and then eventually puts it into some very safe and powerful hands of Jack Howarth, who just powered down that right-hand side. It's good to see BBC that when they got that ball and they got their field position, they executed well. They were getting bogged down at the other end of the field. String of penalties. And who knows how the game would have unfolded if a key player had been ejected with that card. So they're very fortunate they didn't get one down the other end. Now they find themselves at the other end of the field minutes later with a try and potentially cracking the 40-point mark. Annan, right of centre. Pushes it to the left. BBC in the lead, 39 points to 15 over Ipswich Grammar. In the 50th minute of play.
21.
Ali for the restart. Bit of pitch on it. Will land just inside the 22, and he'll find O'Sullivan, who links into the middle with Gordon, who smacks it downtown to find Stowers, of all people, in the middle. He graciously offloads it to Dixon, who puts a shutter step in before throwing in a kick of his own. He finds some available turf out the back. Oh, and Annan, he let it bounce a little bit too much. Now under some pressure inside, he'll send it back. Gordon waiting, and he's looking for some territory himself. And that is a over-kicked touch. So good net gain there for Ipswich Grammar. They've played the kicking game and they've come out on top. We see the back and forth here, but Gordon, he's gone for that kick. And he's once again put Ipswich inside the BBC 22. Out the front, and Fox manages to bat it back before a strong run there from Swain is stripped off, and now BBC back on the counter. It was the Hoff.
Yeah, he's helped.
Now BBC, middle of the field. Trying to work their way out. They don't have the numbers on the short side, but a strong run there from Tom Wynn. Milne.
Off white! Oh, let it come back! Let it come!
And the turnover from Ipswich Grammar, but it was not lawful. And BBC will get a kick out of jail now.
Now, I felt your knees were on the ground, and then also your hands on the ground too, so.
Aaron Pook down there just giving some points of reference to why the penalty was given. Lofty throw from Guest, found its mark for an inside ball from Gordon, will make the ball chart its way back to the left-hand side with Jared Homan. Oh, and the Hoff in space. He's not the biggest one out there, and he's going to duck and weave. Finds a good offload to his second rower, Hugo Percival, who was looking for one, and he found it. Ween came through. BBC 3 metres away. Ween just short, and they have got him wrapped up pretty hard. And
that was held up for too long for me. Held up.
Aaron Pook was hovering centimetres above that. So if anyone was going to know if that thing had hit the grass on the other side of the white line, it was going to be him. But what a run here from Zach Hoff. Zips through, and he knew he couldn't go all the way, so he just needed someone to be running off the hip. Great vision from Percival, and then a wonderful trot from Ween. He's a big guy, but everyone was keeping on the high tackle. Someone just needed to get around those ankles and bring the monster down. But now it'll be a BBC scrum 5 metres out.
Crouch!
And they're hunting for that elusive 40.
Set!
A bit of nostalgia here. That 55 for 12 win the BBC had in 2018. Here we go, big, strong Jack Howarth ploughs through, picks up the hat-trick.
Sorry, mate.
And someone from BBC needs to buy Jack Howarth a new pair of shoelaces because that left boot keeps coming off. Well, I guess it's okay when you're scoring hat-tricks. We see here on the right, find Marlowe just... quick one too, and he's ploughed through three defenders to get there. It's a big ask to bring the man down. Now Annan, little hunt for the extras. BBC cracking 40 points, 44 to 15. A 29 point deficit. And this is a humdinger of a kick. Taj Annan on the right-hand side of the field. I know he's at a long distance. He's got this wind beating into him, right into his face as he stands now. You can see the flags and the Tipuanas behind the goalposts here, just rustling in the wind. Oh, and that wind just bit into it harder than jaws and sent it out to the right-hand side. So conversion unsuccessful. BBC leading 44 points to 15 against home side Ipswich Grammar. Ali short and sharp, looking to find the man, and he did, but it'll be knocked on. And now Oliver Milne will be the recipient of that knocked on ball, and play will continue. So BBC keep coming at Ipswich.
Take a step.
Now the pirouette from Andrew Romano. Put him on Dancing with the Stars. That is sensational. Off the back, and BBC opting for the exit. You just see how strong that wind was. Left foot kick inside 22, nearly finding the opposing 22. Now watch this left foot kick. Seemingly effortless style, not taking anything away from the power of the boys' kick, but when you get high into the column today, definitely breezing far, and a wonderful lineup once again taken by Percival in the middle. The driving maul, though, won't meet completion. Flat passing before Wallace, but too flat it would seem. It's a hard time on the wings for BBC when you've got such big firepower in the centres. Taj Annan and Jack Howarth dominating the carries today, and that one definitely forward.
Danny, fellas, Danny.
We'll use this one.
It's also a very, it's a very surreal and strange sight being at these games, usually with all of the fans and the spectators here and the boys that have already played today cheering this on. It's a different feel, it's a different environment.
We've got to get up, come closer, come up.
We'll come up.
So that,
thanks,
Green.
Big push out, Crouch! Fine!
Short arm going to BBC, early engage. from Ipswich Grammar.
This one's bind. Comes straight in. It's got a bind on the side, okay?
From Marlowe. Quick tap and go. Gives it to Romano, who goes straight in to Xavier Stowers.
I'm at a penalty only.
Now the penalty advantage to BBC. Show and go there from Annan. BBC keeping the ball moving forward. Romano manages to get the steal, but I think there might have been an accidental forward offside rip from Romano, but they'll bring it back to the original infringement from Ipswich Grammar.
Tom off. Captain. It was six, wasn't it? I'm six. I had a chat to you on the run in the first half about discipline with foul play, okay?
Head high.
Yeah. That one was six, just coming straight off his feet with no arms on the man on the ground, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Have a word. Next one's going to go to the bin.
All
right, come on, turn it down. Right here.
So, Aaron Pook, he's had the chat with Ipswich Grammar now. Too many little niggly infringements coming. And someone could be riding the pine and copping a piece of cheese. Harvey Guest throws it in on the 5 metre. Taken clean. BBC hitting the driving maul with speed. Stowers, they big levers. He's trying to plough his way through and find that ball. And he is getting pretty close. He's got hands on Guest, who's got the ball back there. Fimalo might have to pull it off him, but Guest is going to drive through and get the try. Harvey Guest threw a clean ball to his forwards. Looped around, sat on the back, kept his composure under pressure. Big Xavier Stowers was raining in from above, but he kept linked on, head down, shoulder driving forward, ball on the back hip, and trusted the forwards in front of him to keep the momentum going. And just see, really great lineout from here. And Stowers had a huge effort to try and get himself into a position where he could affect some change, but BBC, they just kept ploughing forward, and Guest, he really committed here and then backed it in. From Annan, not there.
Oi.
Just hasn't been a day for the kickers. Only two conversions through the post today. As we enter the final 10 minutes of play, BBC 49, Ipswich Grammar 15. BBC sending a real message to the competition. They've got to be in people's finals calculations. Annan offloads. Howarth with a hat-trick. Howarth, he might be going all the way to look for more. Graciously offloads it. Left-hand side. Here's Homan. Back through to Wallace. Wallace can't get away from Stowers. Loose ball out the back. BBC have got players out to the right.
Now good. No!
Now penalty given away from Leandro Tupi.
Scrum. Scrum. Line out.
BBC in a commanding position, 49 points to 15. They're really just going to run through the playbook now. Because this time next week, they're going to be at the back end of one of their biggest games of the season as they take on Southport.
Watch. Entry your side here, Cooper.
It's a short season. Only 3 weeks remain after this one, with the final week containing two matches, a Saturday and then the following Friday, as that'll be the end of term three, and that's when they want a lot of these sports for GPS to be wrapping up so they can play catch-up. I believe the only one remaining after the break will be track and field, and that'll be a short season for them too, but they're the changes that everyone's had to adhere to if we wanted to see the boys get on to their respective fields of play in 2020. BBC have rolled a few substitutions in as well.
Crouch!
Preserve some of the players. And start working towards their next battle next weekend. Marlowe throws it in. Picked off the back by Ween. Ween goes on the short side, fends off defenders, but Ween will get driven out of the field of play before he can get that ball down.
Stay here. Keep him here.
Now, Ipswich Grammar feeding their own line out, 5 metres out from their try line. Taken clean at the top by Fox. Now they'll throw it into the centre. Now BBC on the counter. Up the middle goes Homan. That long shaggy hair just flicking as he throws the steps in. Oh, the big show and go from Annan. Straight up the middle and finds the Hoff. A little bit of a shimmy there from Hansen. The front row is getting involved. That one goes right at the top of Howarth. Here's Williams. Williams, he's last year he was in the Gold Coast under 16 Helensvale's Hog Champion side. It's his first year at BBC. So he'll probably be someone we'll be seeing over the next couple of years in the competition. Another shaggy pass there from Faimalu before it gets intercepted by King, who wears a bit of a seatbelt. Alley there gets one more off. But it'll fall away from Dolph at Schulberg, who will recover. Schulberg throws some steps, but BBC defence is giving him a bit of trouble. Now Ipswich Grammar, ball in hand. That is a penta cutout to eventually fall with Saipili Tamillo.
No, shooter.
King with a wonderful step finds Ali. He looks on the right hand side, and here we go. Dolph at Schulberg, right hand side. Dolph at Schulberg. He's got King on the inside. High tackle. Schulberg, selfless, through to King, and he's over in the corner. Ethan King gets the try. Behind that wonderful clump of golden cane here on the field. But a wonderful try there, and Dolph at Schulberg really showing why his name should be thrown in the ring for higher honours beyond this year. And that man who scored, Ethan King, he's been ever-present all day, and we see it starts with him, the big step. Ali's involved here, gets off to Dolph at Schulberg, who comes through. Hoff can't get him right there. Defenders still lining up. It's a bit of a high shot from Homan. He keeps going selflessly back into King. He probably could have finished it himself. Wallace didn't have the position to run him down. But it'll be a nice consolation try as we enter the final 5 minutes of the match. Ipswich Grammar, they're going to try and claw back as much as they can. But BBC, that is an undeniable lead. 49 points to Ipswich's 20. Could be 22 if we can see Luke Dixon master this gusty, gusty wind blowing at Ipswich Grammar School. Conversion unsuccessful. Ipswich Grammar trailing now 20 points to 49. Just under 3 minutes remaining. And BBC, that 49, it's just going to be like trying to go to sleep with a mosquito at night. It's just going to annoy them. They just want to get one more point. Crack that 50 mark. It's a big milestone. Hey, they could even go one further. Try and beat the score that their predecessors did in 2018, which was 55. So BBC, big statement across the competition. And we'll wait till full time here to get an update on the scores around the grounds. I don't believe we will. Now Ipswich Grammar inside their own half. Can they finish on a high note? Nick Mitchell showing some good pirouettes, but Perrenfrey Marlow offside by a long way will give away a penalty. Final couple of minutes of play.
1 minute, Captain, where is it?
As we can see, not even a busload of kids will be heading back to school today. It is a vastly different environment. You see the bus bays up the top ready to receive 5, 6, 7 buses. Just one. Everyone's coming, playing, and then leaving. It's very different to what everyone's used to. But we thank everyone who is adhering to those rules, which give us the ability to still be able to play the game. BBC are hunting. Ween's in there.
He's out of it. That's fine.
Nearly shoulder deep trying to enforce a turnover. Stowers. What a big game he's had today.
Let it come for green.
Pook says nothing wrong with that. It's been pilfered and taken by BBC. Here's Queen. By Marlow to the left. Finds Hoff. Once more. Once more out. Finds Guy Wallace. Wallace! Oh, he's knocked it on, I think. Right at the end. I'm not sure. We'll have to wait for the touchy on that one. But he copped a big blow. We're going to have to wait and see what happens here.
Oh, yeah. So I don't have touch ball ground. Okay?
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so no try?
Okay. Okay, fellas. We have no conclusive grounding here, so it's going to be knock on. That is full time.
But that is
so
full
no try,
time,
no
and BBC will claim a massive victory. 49 points to 20 over Ipswich Grammar School here in round 3 of GPS Rugby. What a big afternoon it was, but standout performance. Jack Howarth picks up a hat-trick of tries for BBC. We're also seeing tries awarded to Homan, Gordon, Vimalo, Hoff, Guest. And on the other side, it was Kyle Coleman who went missing in the second half. He was either subbed off and might have had a bit of an injury, but he had a bit of hope in the Ipswich sales and did some good work out wide. It was a massive game for all, and they're all now going to be looking forward to next week, to what the future will hold for them. And I think for BBC, it's going to be a make-or-break match if they're chasing down that elusive premiership. And we will also be seeing Ipswich Grammar back in action as well. So we are almost done here at Ipswich Grammar School. It's been a wonderful afternoon of rugby, but BBC too strong over the duration of the match, 49 points to 20 over Ipswich Grammar. We thank everyone for tuning in for this broadcast, and we can now bring you the scores from around the grounds. And as we saw, Terrace getting the win over Churchy, 38 points to 24, another high-scoring affair. 15 all between Brisbane Grammar and the Southport School. I don't know what you're doing now, but I would be jumping across to check that one out. And Nudgee College on the other match that's nearly up on the range on the western side have done really well, 38 points to 7. So there are some big collision courses on the way for GPS Rugby in the coming weeks, and you can guarantee that it is going to be brought to you live and free thanks to our wonderful broadcast partners, Double Take Sports. Well, that about wraps us up here for Saturday afternoon. We're all going to get inside where it's a little bit warmer and less windy. I'm Martin Lipier. Thank you so much for joining us. Make sure you tune into all the socials during the week to find out all of your information about the competition and see some awesome replays of your favourite players. We'll catch you next time.